Hello, my name is Leo Rivera, and this is a meter chalk talk. And today we are going to talk about infiltration rates and how those measurements eventually lead into calculating hydraulic conductivity. Infiltration rates are the measure of how fast water or other liquid may move through a porous medium. In our case, typically we're measuring that movement through soil. And we oftentimes use this term infiltration rate to represent a lot of different things about how water is moving through soil. But really it's important to understand that your infiltration rate is one, something that changes over time, especially as the soil saturates or as the conditions in the soil change, the wetting front moves deeper. Ultimately, our end goal is to understand hydraulic conductivity, but measuring the infiltration rate is eventually how we get to that calculation of hydraulic conductivity. And here you have a graph that shows a typical infiltration rate measurement and how that looks over time. So you can see here that initially the infiltration rate is going to be a lot higher initially at this stage right here. And as we move further along in time, the infiltration rate decreases, kind of looking like an exponential decay function. But eventually it's going to reach a steady state value. Now, in some cases, it could take hours to days to actually reach that true steady state value that we're trying to get to. And that's not really feasible when we're trying to make a measurement. So normally what we're going to do is measure infiltration rate for a period of time. So maybe we're going to measure from the beginning here to this time point here. And ultimately our goal is to then take that and turn that infiltration rate measurement into a hydraulic conductivity value. And so let's dive a little bit deeper into actually what that looks like. So here we have a few equations where we're looking at infiltration rate. Here you can see in this equation that infiltration rate, when you calculate it, there are several factors that actually go into impacting it. And one of the two primary factors are your matrix potential and how that changes over time. And then the gravitational component. And in theory, the gravitational component is going to stay fairly constant. And you can see that here where it's primarily mostly equal to one. But over time, that matrix component, as the soil becomes more saturated, is going to become zero. So as that measurement goes on longer and longer, eventually your infiltration rate would actually approximately equal the hydraulic conductivity. Now you'll have to correct for certain things like ponding heights, because there are other components that impact that, the how fast water moves into soil. But if you correct for those things like ponding height, eventually you can get to your hydraulic conductivity. In theory, if we were able to infiltrate water into soil for long enough and let it approach a true steady state, we could use that value to determine what the hydraulic conductivity is. But in reality, you can't really do it until you reach a true full steady state. Typically, we refer to reaching a quasi-steady state, and there's a whole lot of things that go into actually taking that value to calculate hydraulic conductivity. I don't want to dive super deep into all those different ways of calculating that, because it all depends on the tools that you're using and some of the antecedent factors about the soil and various other things. We dive into that in other virtual seminars, and so you're welcome to go back and look at those and take a look at some of those calculations. But one piece I did want to focus on is when we talk about hydraulic conductivity, it's really important to understand what it is we actually are trying to understand about the hydraulic conductivity. Because one, we need to know how the hydraulic conductivity changes as the soil conditions change, as it's wetter or drier, because it does change. So here we have a graph that shows the hydraulic conductivity curves for three different soil types: a well-structured clayey soil, a structureless sandy soil, and a poorly structured clayey soil. And there's a couple things that I really want you to take away from this. One is that hydraulic conductivity is going to change as the water status of the soil changes, or as the water potential changes. So you can see here how this graph shows in the middle here, we have our saturated point at zero. And as it gets drier or less, the matrix potential becomes less negative, the hydraulic conductivity changes. And that's because the amount of water that is actually retained in the soil is changing. And so your matrix potential is playing a bigger role in the ability to move water. But also the pores that can contribute are changing because the larger pores are not able to contribute to the water movement in unsaturated conditions due to the matrix forces in soil. The other piece that I want you to take away from this is also the impact that the different soil types have, and that there's other factors beyond just soil texture that impact hydraulic conductivity, especially as we get more towards a saturated state. So you can see here, for example, with the structured clay soil, that you know it's going to have very similar unsaturated hydraulic conductivity until we start getting close to saturation, and those larger pores that are present in the structure of the soil really impact how fast that water can transmit water, that soil can transmit water. And so it has a really big impact on what those curves look like and ultimately what the measurement is going to look like as well. Ultimately, when we're talking about infiltration rates, it's important to understand what our end goal is. Are we trying to understand saturated hydraulic conductivity, or are we trying to understand unsaturated hydraulic conductivity? And so that's just a really basic overview of infiltration rates and how they're measured, and then how that eventually turns into hydraulic conductivity. And in the future, maybe we'll dive a little bit deeper into some of those equations that we use to calculate hydraulic conductivity.